The Secretary General returned from the region encouraged by what he deemed a demonstrable seriousness by both President Abbas and Prime Minister Netanyahu to resume direct talks, despite skepticism from their domestic bases, as the only viable path through which a two-state solution may still be achieved. The international community has long supported the vision of a two-state solution and now has a responsibility to give these efforts a chance. But the onus to sustain an enabling environment lies with the parties. Both should refrain from actions that risk undermining the prospects of negotiations. And we urge them to act responsibly and with restraint. Concurrently, any substantial political initiative must yield early dividends in the immediate period ahead, with tangible improvements to security and socio-economic conditions for Israelis and Palestinians alike.
In accordance with Rule 39,
we do not underestimate the challenges ahead and the momentous efforts required to sustain and successfully conclude negotiations within the prescribed time frame. And yet, 20 years of peace efforts have also demonstrated that fair, reasonable, and legitimate solutions can be found for the key issues dividing the parties. It is for the negotiators to identify and narrow these gaps, and for their leaders to take decisions in the best interest of their peoples.
Item 2 on the agenda, and I now give the floor.